Hello friends, in this short tutorial I will tell you how to build a Python data logging system that logs data from an Arduino and creates a CSV file on a disk. In this case, we will be saving the file on the Linux system. Now I'll show you how the code works. You can run it on the command line like this. You can press enter right now and it will ask for the serial port number. So you have to give the serial port number and I'll explain how to get that later. Right now you just put this one. This port number is specific to my system. Yours will be different. So here I will be just demonstrating this one. Now you can press enter. Now it has created a log file using the current date and time, and the login interval is 1 second. So the system is now logging and the data will be saved into a CSV file. Now you can exit from this particular script by pressing Ctrl C like this. Now it will show that data logging is terminated and you can view the output by going to the directory in which this particular script is present. So I'll show you how it's done. This is the CSV file that was created by this particular script. Now if you open it, you will see the log data which you can use it for analysis. Here I will show you the number, date, time and the data, that is the temperature sensor data that is coming from the Arduino. Now in this tutorial we'll be dealing mostly with the Linux specific parts. While I have already explained the code and the circuit diagram and how to build the whole thing in my previous videos, I will show that right now. This is our YouTube channel and these are the, you can go to this particular video which will show you how the whole thing is done and will also give you a line by line explanation of the system. While the second video, this one, would give you the hardware connections between the Arduino and the temperature sensors. And in this video, I will tell you how to run the whole thing on a Linux system. Here we'll be using Ubuntu system right now. Now if you like this video, do like and subscribe, and if you have any doubts, please leave it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Now we have a textual version of our tutorial hosted on our website, which you can browse and read it for free. The link is in the description. You can also download the code from this website. This is the website and you can go to the source code section here, this one. And then you can download it directly from the GitHub. Here I have already reached the website, the GitHub repo. This is the GitHub repo and the codes both for the Arduino and the Python set are here. And you can download it to your system. For example, in our case, the Ubuntu Linux system. And then you can run our code. Now you can go to code here and from there you can press download zip. Then it will download to your downloads folder. Now you can use the code from that folder. Here we'll be using Ubuntu 22.04 LTS. Now first thing we should do is to check whether Python is installed on the system or not. For that, you can open the command prompt and type Python 3. Now you can check whether PySerial is installed it or not. You can type it by try typing import serial. Now if PySerial is installed, there won't be an issue. Now we'll just press enter. And it is saying that module not found. So we'll have to install the PySerial module. So you can close the Python 3. Now we need to install PySerial. The easiest way is to use the pip installer. So you can check whether pip is installed on your system. For that, clear this one. And you can type Python 3. minus m pip. So it is saying that the pip is not installed, so we have to install the pip module. For that, we will first update the apt repository. So you can type sudo apt update. After that, you have to give the password. Now we will install the pip installer. For that, you have to type sudo apt install python 3-pip. Now you can just press Y here. Now we have finished installing pip. Now you can check the version. Now the pip version is 22.0.2. Now using pip, we can install PySerial. You can also see the installed libraries by using pip list. Now we can't see any PySerial, so we have to install PySerial. So that for that, we can do something like this. Now it is saying that it has installed the PySerial. You can check it by using pip list. So you can see from here, we have PySerial 3.5 installed here. Now you can also check it using the Python prompt. Type Python 3. Now you can import . Now we are going to identify the serial port number of the Arduino. Now in the case of Windows, it will be something like COM1, COM2, COM3. Here we are using Linux, so it will be different. The usual format will be something like TTY USB0 or TTY ACM0. So here I am using an Arduino Uno to be exact. Now you can connect the Arduino Uno to your USB port of the Linux installation. After connecting the USB, you can run the following command. First you have to sudo, then you have to say dmesg, then vertical slash, and then you press tail. Then you have to give the password. Now from here you can see that you can see the details of the USB device. These are the lines which we require. As you can see from here, it is a USB device is found. The vendor ID, product ID is there. Now it also shows that it's an Arduino here, and the serial number of the Arduino. We require only this one, TTY ACM0. This is the serial port number of the Arduino. This is what you have to put it instead of COM1 or COM2. You have to write it as TTY ACM0. Now we have identified the number. Unlike other operating systems, for example Windows, we need to add our username. Here my name is Rahul, so the username is also Rahul. So it has to be assigned to a particular groups, for example to the groups TTY and dial out, then only the system will allow you access to the serial port. So you can view the groups to which your username is joined by using the groups command. So I'll just, it's groups and your username. So it will be Rahul here. So you can see that my name is part of the following groups like cd-rom, sudo, plugdev, etc. Now we have to add our add me to the groups ttyn dial out. For that we have to use a usermod command. Now clear the system and we will use the usermod command. For that you have to use the sudo, then usermod, then minus small a hyphen capital G, and the group to which you want to be part. So here I want to be part of TTY. Then I have to give my username. So that will be Rahul. Then I will add myself to dial out. So I will just change it here. Now this is dial out. Now you can check it again by using the groups command. So I will use this command and I will see that I am part of the TTY and dial out groups. Now I have access to the serial port. It's much better if you log off from your system and log on again so that the changes are written. So I'll do that right now. I will log off from the system. Now I have logged back into the system after configuring the groups. Now we'll run our program. But before that, you have to download the Arduino code into the Arduino Uno. I have already done that. After that, you have to connect the Arduino to the PC's USB port. Then you have to identify the correct port number. In our case, it is TTYACM0. So I will now run the code. I've already downloaded the code, so I have placed in a directory called logger. There are three Python files. This one is the main file which will be running right now. So you can type Python 3. Then the name of the file you have to run. So this is not required. So you can press enter. Now it will show a small dialog, something like this, the name of the code, and you can exit from this code by pressing Ctrl plus C, and it will create a log file using the current date and time, and it will also display the version of the Linux on which it is running and the CPython version also. So now we have to give the port number. Now, instead of just giving TTY USB, we have to give the full name, like slash dev slash TTY. Okay, so it will be slash dev slash TTY ACM 0. And you can press enter. Now, our data logging system is active and it is logging data from the Arduino. So this data will be written into a CSV file on the same directory on which the Python code is running. So if we go to the folder, you will see a text file, a CSV file. So you can stop the running code here by pressing Ctrl plus C. So now this is finished. Now you can go into the folder and I will show you the log. So this file is the log. You can double click it. It's a text file. Now you can see the number, date, time, and AN1, AN2, AN3. These are analog channels which correspond to specific temperature. Now this is the date and this is the time right now. And you can find the temperature values, all four of them. So we have taken around 29 readings and you can find the number here and the date. So this can be used for building your own data logging system using an Arduino. If you want more channels, you can add it, because I'm only using 4 right now. If you want other values, you can include use the other ADC channels. If you are using something like an Arduino Mega, you can get more channels. You can also use the same code to interface with the other sensors like humidity or pressure sensors, and you can log the data into the CSV file. Now we have other code like Python Arduino symbol and Python Arduino symbol query. These codes are actually a simple version of the main one, this one. Here we will, the idea is to teach only the basic idea, a basic framework without the bells and whistles. So I will open this thing. So you can see that this code is relatively simple, but it does the same thing. Now, one more thing I want to tell you is that when you are running this particular code, the COM number is actually hard-coded. For example, in this line 37, you can see that it is COM4 and the baud rate is 9600. So if you are running the code on Linux system, change this particular line into /dev /ttyacm0. Otherwise, it will not work and it will cause an error. You have to use the serial port number corresponding to your particular Linux system. Now, the baud rate is 9600 here, and the system will show the name of the file here. 21 August, 22 hours, 28 minutes, and 29 seconds. So you can also set the logging interval. Here I have set it as 1 seconds. You can go into the code and change it to anything you want. We are also putting a 3-second delay here, because when you are opening the serial port, the Arduino board will get reset. So it will take some time for it to come back on online again. So there is this 3-second delay. If you are using the code for other boards, this delay is not required. This is only specific for Arduino. And all the data that is logged into the system is shown here. So you can check that. To exit from this particular system, you have to press the C, the combination Control plus C. So it will cause a signal which is caught by the Python script, and it will terminate the data logging system. You can find the whole details in our video, which I'll link it in the description. So do like and subscribe.